albums, a Grammy Award winner, and lately has become a mom as well.
Her greatest accomplishment, yeah.
And this new album is her latest, Warm and Tender, and here she is, Olivia Newton-John.
I cannot believe it. I've been looking for a little dog for my little girl. And I'm out there in the back. I'm looking at this little dog, and he's so beautiful. And the gentleman from Yuppie Puppy, Jordan, said, would you like the dog? I said, are you kidding? And I called my husband, and thank goodness he wasn't home.
So that's how
so
I got
tried,
two of them.
Are these wonderful dogs?
They're the,
she has two.
I adore them.
It won me over. Look at me.
Oh, look at
me.
Can we see the face, Olivia? Look.
Well, let's see. We're going to have to name that puppy, right?
Yes.
Why don't we call it Regis?
No.
I want something to be called Regis around.
Is it a little boy or a little girl?
A little boy. She's probably going to call it Toto after the Wizard of Oz, I think.
But does she know? How old is your baby now?
She's 3 and a half.
3 and a half years?
Yes.
Oh, well, she's no baby anymore. So she's just right the right age for a little puppy.
Oh, she will love him.
So you have them, right?
We have two. Yeah. We'd adore them.
You know, they don't always look like this. They change. They're determined shepherds. Determined shepherds.
Olivia was a great animal lover long before she had a little girl. I'll never forget you being here and saying, all of a sudden, after the baby, the dog is a dog.
That's right.
And the horse is a horse.
And congratulations.
Thank you.
Happy for you. You're going into the best time of your life now.
Well, thank you. I must tell you, I was
You remember when you were 4 or 5 months along?
I do. Mm-hmm. How are you feeling?
I feel great. Thank you. I was saying at the beginning of the show how much your album has meant to me the last couple of days. I got it about 3 days ago and have not taken it off.
Oh,
it is
nice. Thank
sensational.
You.
Yes.
It makes me cry.
We're getting very maternal around here.
Yeah.
She wants to hum lullabies to me all the time.
We were driving home in the car yesterday, and I'd just been given the cassette, and I'm listening to it. Tears are streaming down my face. And my husband goes, should I put Gladys Knight in?
Yeah, well, I made it for her.
So. You selected all of these songs yourself,
I
Olivia?
I did. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
And wrote the words on the
I wrote the words
song.
On the title song for Chloe.
Some of them are old songs. That have always appealed to you, I guess.
Yes,
but they fit the moment, don't they?
Yeah, well, I when we listen to songs that I had to work to sing to my daughter. I mean, so they'll love songs, but they work to sing to your child.
Well, yeah, that was a beautiful song.
But now here's one that I haven't thought about in a long, long time. Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
Uh-huh. But the way she does it, it's different than the way
What's
you
the
and I do
What's the next line? Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
How I wonder where you are.
What's
anybody know?
What am I, the only jackass here who doesn't know it?
There are children watching, Rich.
I did that with harp. All the lullabies I did with a harpist, and she was pregnant at the time, so I thought that was a good omen.
Mm. It's just a great ecological message throughout it. You're, as a mother now, much more concerned about the planet we live on, huh?
Oh, very much so. I think the minute I had Chloe, my priorities changed. And, you know, now I care about the world for her much more than I care for myself.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so I want to help to keep it clean and green, and I hope that she can breathe the air and drink the water, and these are the things I really am conscious of now. So inside I put 10 points of things that people can do, because I think everyone wants to help the environment, but they don't know what they can do.
We all say, I'm only one person, what can I do?
Yeah.
You give 10 steps of what one person could do.
But we can do things, and it's easy to do. You can recycle your garbage, and if you're a young mum, you can use biodegradable diapers or washable
or
diapers
cloth.
Or cloth. And I mean, there are a lot of things you can do. Small things, but they all add up if we all do them.
That biodegradable is really something, isn't it? When you think that actually that's going to all disappear. You know.
Well, they're all landfills, just full of
diapers. From here to the moon.
That's right, sure.
Yeah.
All right.
And this is made on recycled paper, the album cover itself. I'm very
Is this dog recyclable too? Everything's recyclable these days.
And if you don't like the album, you can eat it.
We have a clip from the album. This is the Reach Out For Me song. All right, shall we take a look at this now? Olivia Newton-John, Reach Out For Me from Warm and Tender.
I'm gonna love you.
You wrote some words here for one of the songs, right?
I did, yes. Yeah.
Could you recite just a little bit for us?
Yeah, I haven't cried yet today, Olivia. Go ahead.
Well, I wrote the title track. John Farrar, who's my producer, wrote the melody. And I wanted to say everything. It's very hard to say everything in a song without being too heavy, but this is the first verse of Warm and Tender. If I don't cry now. Warm and tender is my prayer for your world that I surrender to my girl. All my life I've waited for the angel you are. You're the dream that I knew you'd be, and I love you completely, my Chloe.
And there you are, right up there on the set.
Oh, boy.
She's crying.
Well, I put on the album, the first thing, I didn't really know what to expect.
Are you going to cry now?
Stop it. And the first song is called Jenny Rebecca, and it's 4 days old.
How do you like the world so far?
How do you like the world so far? And then he says, what a lucky, 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 lucky girl you are. And then talks about all the things that children have ahead of them. And you wish for nothing but good things ahead of them.
That's true. My father sent me that song. And in fact, the first two songs on the album he sent to me on a tape. The second song, which was the nativity song, he used to sing to me when I was a little girl.
An old Welsh carol, right?
No, it was Czechoslovakian nativity song. I dug it out of the archives. And you want to be in on this, don't you?
Oh. Huh?
Look at this. You're crying, she's hugging the dog, and right now Geraldo's in a topless donut shop. What's going on here? And I gotta get with him. Olivia, here's the new album, Warm and Tender. Well, you saw
very
the reaction
special,
here. It's a special album for a special time in your life. Thanks so much for being with us.
Accommodations for some guests.